So here's our setup. I'm sitting in the kiddie pool next to the water balloon suspended from the ceiling with the clamp and ratchet strap. We have our DSLR camera, two flashes, and our iPhone, along with our backstop for our pellet trap. Now, this iPhone, when it hears a sound over a certain threshold, and you can set the threshold yourself, you can ramp it up to where it's got to be real high or somewhat high. I just laid it, got me. I just laid it on top of the flash, and I shot the pellet gun 30 feet that way. Here we go. So when it hears a sound, that's what happens. Now we're going to turn the lights out. Producer, can you please... Producer, no, don't stop it. Did you stop it? Can you turn the lights out? Then this, we're going to simulate what it would look like on film the best we can when this was shot. So we would turn the lights out, and then you would hear I would have somebody actuate the camera shutter, so you'd hear a click on the DSLR opening the shutter and holding it open, and then you'd hear the bang of the pellet gun. Then the person working the shutter would release the shutter button, you would hear the shutter close, and then someone would turn the lights back on. Producer, turn lights on, please. There you have it. A couple of things to mention. When you're shooting a pellet gun or anything that involves projectile motion, you should take the proper safety precautions. I'm not going to go through them all, nor am I an expert. Eyeglasses, body armor, office chairs that you can roll around to make sure you're behind, a pellet backstop, making sure whatever's behind the backstop is okay. You got to prepare for pellets to bounce. We had about 5 or 6 pellets bounce because they did not penetrate the second balloon. Five pellets, the producer tells me. So these things you have to account for. Also, things to account for. Your equipment may get wet. Maybe a good idea to put Ziploc bags on the flashes. It may be better to get a telephoto lens so you can back that camera up instead of having to have it so close. One thing I will demonstrate, is this what it sounds like to have your shutter open? Close. Open. Close. On your DSLR, recommended camera settings are as follows. Your ISO at 800. Bulb. Shooting mode. If your camera doesn't have a B for bulb, you can put it in manual and do the same thing. And you may find your bulb exposure hidden inside the manual. A remote trigger so you can push the button, open the shutter, and close it. And you want to shoot on an aperture somewhere around F8 to F11. Now you'll need to adjust those settings accordingly. You know, if you can take a little bit of aperture away, get down to F8, keep your ISO a little bit lower, that's always good. At the end of the day, you really need that depth of field to cover a good 18 inches so you get everything in focus from the water balloon. And that's really all I have. You know, that's the basics. Any questions, you can leave comments below. And I appreciate you paying attention through 5 videos. I forgot to go over the flash setting. You want to set the flash on the lowest power possible. This would be 1/128. Your zoom, I usually run between 70 and 80 millimeters. Again, this puts more of a spotlight instead of a widespread beam, so that you'll just have to fool around with it and be creative. But again, 1/128 on the lowest power setting is where you'll want that flash to be for you to stop that action as good as possible.